Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another vlog. Today I am biting the bullet. I'm going to get my first COVID vaccine. I know I'm a bit late to the party, but I will explain all later once I've had it done. So let's go. Okay guys, I've had my COVID vaccine. Extremely proud of myself. I know it, for a lot of people it's such a, you know, normal thing to have done, like a vaccine, but I am absolutely petrified of needles. So when it comes to having any sort of vaccination or anything, I literally freak out. So I'm pretty impressed that I actually had this done this morning. I'm currently at the yard. I've got a lesson with Chase in about 45 minutes, so I'm gonna get him in, brush him, pamper him for a bit, and then have our lesson. It's gonna be very hot. I'm sun creamed up and yeah, I'm ready to go. I will tell you a bit more later about why I decided to go for the COVID vaccine a bit later than everybody else. There are reasons behind, but yeah, I'll explain it later. But yeah, let's go and get ready for our lesson.
Good night, Chase. Are you enjoying that? Oh, yes, I think that's the spot, isn't it? Very itchy pony, aren't you? Very itchy. I'm literally just like sort of massaging him with this horsewear little massager. It's rubber, so nothing too horrible. But he seems to really enjoy it. He's like, Mum, more? Nice little treat for our lesson. I'm sweating already. It's going to be a hot one.
Okay, so I thought I'd set you up just while I'm finishing brushing Chase. So like I said, I said to you that I'd explain as to why I had my vaccine so late. Basically with my anxiety, I'm absolutely petrified of needles. So one, that's a really big deal for me. And secondly, like, so many contradicting views on the jab. You know, I've spoken to so many people and it's just really hard. I don't know what to do, to be honest. But no, I decided to have it because, like I said to my friends and family, I am meant to be going up to London in September. I've also going to lots of theatre productions in Southampton, and now that the restrictions have eased, well, on Monday they'll be Monday they'll be easing, if I actually can talk. Today's Friday, so people are going to be like sat literally like next to you, so I just wanted to feel a bit more protected and a bit more safe, as I am on the more vulnerable. I had pneumonia when I was about 16, and so my lungs are still weak. I still suffer from it now, especially when I ride. If I do a lot of exercise, I find it hard to take in a really deep breath. So as for that, that's the reason why I decided to have it. Also, there are, like I said in one of my previous videos, that there is a possibility of a chance to Disneyland Paris this December. I'm really hoping it goes ahead, but if it does, at least I'm vaccinated, because as of, I think it's July the 19th, to go into the Disney parks, you have to have something called I think it's a sanitary pass, something like that, which means you have to show that you have had both your vaccinations to get into the parks, and you also have to take a COVID test. I think it's like 24 hours, 48 hours before you enter. You can obviously check all these guidelines on Magic Breaks, Disneyland Paris, or you can obviously go onto the government website and they will give you all the information about the obviously changes coming up. But yeah, so that's basically my reasoning why. I find it really hard as well, because my parents as well are very, like, different in thoughts. So it was really hard to actually make the decision myself to do it, but we've done it, we're good. So it's in me, can't do anything about it now. Got my second jab, I think it's in about 8 weeks, which is fine, and then I'm fully vaccinated. So I am really pleased with myself, and I'm on the way to getting back to some sort of normality. So fingers crossed, don't have too many side effects. At the moment I feel fine, but it's only been like 2 hours, not even that. Yeah, so I'm gonna go and chase and get ready for my lesson, as my instructor's just messaging me to say she's on her way. Right, I'll see you a bit later.
Hey, where's the drums?
You're never going out of style. Ooh, pretty baby, this world might have gone crazy. The way you save me, who could blame me when I just wanna make you smile? I wanna thrill you like Michael, I wanna kiss you like Prince. Let's get it on like Marvin, yeah, like Hathaway. Write a song for you like this. You're over my head, I'm out of my mind, thinking I was wrong in the wrong time. One of a kind, living in a world gone plastic. Baby, you're so classic.
Yeah, yeah, so classic.
Baby, you're so classic.
Yeah, yeah.
Baby, ooh, baby, you're so classic. 4,000 roses, anything for you to notice. All the way to serenade you, doing it's not your style. I'ma pick you up in a Cadillac like a gentleman, bring it glamour back, keep it real to real in the way I feel. I could walk you down the aisle. I wanna do you like Michael, I wanna kiss you like Prince. Let's get it on like Marvin, yeah, like Hathaway. Write a song for you like this. You're over my head, I'm out of my mind, thinking I was grown in the wrong time. It's like I'm rewind, everything is so throwback-y. I kinda like it, I get out of my league. Old school street, like a movie star, fuck the silver screen. I'm one of a kind, living in a world gone plastic. Baby, you're so classic. Baby, you're so classic.
Baby, you're class and baby, you're sick. I never met a girl like you ever till we met. A star in the 40s and a fold in the 50s. Got me tripping out like 60s. Hippies, queen of the discotheque. A 70s dream and an 80s best. Hepburn, Beyonce, Marilyn, Massive. Girl, you're timeless. Just so
you're
best.
Over my head, I'm out of my mind. Thinking I was wrong in the wrong time. It's not a rewind. Everything was so throwbackage. I kinda like it, how you're out of my league.
That
kills me, makes me feel alive. Baby, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Burn down this river every turn. Hope is our four-letter word. Make that money, watch it burn. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. And I feel something so wrong. We're doing the right thing. I could lie, could lie, could lie. Everything that drowns me makes me wanna fly. Baby, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Makes me feel alive. Baby, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars.
He'll never see you cry, pretends he doesn't know.
boy, did you get one? Did you? Oh mate, you still gotta get the second one. Hello, it is 2 days later after I had my COVID vaccination. It is now Sunday. I had it on Friday. I thought I'd leave it a little bit longer just so I could tell you if I had any side effects and if so, like how I felt. I had the Pfizer vaccine and I was very lucky that all I had was a bit of a sore arm. To be fair, I thought I was going to have more side effects from that. I do understand that I think after your, if you don't suffer with any side effects on your first vaccination, that you have more of a chance of suffering than on your second. So yeah, I am aware of that, don't worry. I did also though, a little hint is I took some ibuprofen or paracetamol, whichever one you use, after I had the jab, so that it kept any symptoms at bay. So that's just a little tip that I would definitely use and would definitely use again. I had a great lesson on Chase on Friday, as you would have seen from the footage. And yeah, I'm hoping to come back with you this week with some exciting news. I'm not sure yet if how exciting it's going to be, whether it's all going to go ahead or not, but you'll all understand more when I finally announce. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching this. If you are going to go and have your COVID vaccines, you know, I wish you all the best. You'll be okay. For someone who's absolutely scared stiff of needles, I was absolutely fine. So you will be too. Obviously, we have no idea what is going to be happening in the future regarding COVID. I know tomorrow is the end of lockdown number 3. It doesn't mean that the virus is gone or that it is going anywhere anytime soon, but hopefully we might be on the road back to normality now. Fingers crossed anyway, because lockdown's doing my head in now. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and I look forward to seeing you again next time. Bye.